very, very afraid. If I now go, what's going to become of me? So I refused to go, but it was called me.
Precious, you don't have any choice. This is what is going on. This is how it's going to be. You need to prostitute.
It's 50 years.
Oh my God.
How much did she say?
She said I should pay 20,000 euros. I was to pay 20,000 euros. I was like, no problem. No problem, because I really don't have any choice. I just arrived. I don't know how to go. I don't know where to go. I was very, very confused. I was frustrated at that moment. I was, is this the kind of life I'm planning for myself? Is this how I'm going to end it? So there was one thing that a white man released inside the condom. It's very horrible. What if this thing enter inside of me? Maybe I would just, same with my friend here. She said a white man released blood. Blood. She see it. When I told my mother, she buy me red condom so that if they release anything, I will not be seeing it again. So that is it. It's very risky.
The only way they can make money, because they don't have legal documents, is through the sex trade, according to the pimps, who are Nigerian women known as madams, who essentially own several girls in a sort of stable of women, keep them in houses, whether they're in and around Naples, whether they're in the north of the country, depending on what community they're in, the madam determines what the girl will owe. Say she owes 35,000 euro. That seems to be right now what girls owe when they get across the sea, when they end up working for a madam. The going rate for a Nigerian woman for a for fellatio is 10 to 15 euro. For a simple hand job is 5 to 10 euro. And for intercourse is 20 euro. She can charge double if the man doesn't wear a condom.
Persone che non vengono riconosciute vengono rispedite qua, ok? O negli altri paesi dell'Africa, o qualcuno riesce a passare per Tamarra 7 qui in Algeria.
Abbia un'età che va dai 16 a 7 anni fino a massima 24 anni. E questo accade perché evidentemente sono anche in una condizione di maggiore vulnerabilità. Nella appunto strategia dei trafficanti è più semplice convincere queste giovani donne a lasciare i propri paesi per tentare questa avventura europea, e mi sento di dire che in taluni casi la loro giovane età non le mette nelle condizioni di capire il vero rischio a cui stanno andando incontro, perché se qualcuna già sa, anche più di una, che il loro arrivo in Italia è finalizzato alla pratica della prostituzione, nessuno immagina come questa verrà portata avanti, sotto minaccia, violenze, abusi perpetrati dagli stessi trafficanti, forme di vera e propria schiavitù.
When I get to the street the first day, I was very, very angry, and I'm crying because I don't know, because I'm very small. I look into myself, I can't do prostitution because I'm very young. What will I tell my parents? What will I tell my mother? And even me too. How will I start it? I don't know. She was threatening me that if I refuse, she's going to send me back to Nigeria. She's going to take me to the Carabinieri, the Polizia, that I'm doing this, I'm doing that. So I was very scared. I didn't even know anything. I was just like, what will I do? Let me just do it. And she forced me to.
That they cannot contact their lawyer that they are using. They are going to.
They take me there to swear. There's one shrine that is there. They said if I refuse to pay her money, the spirit that is in this cemetery, they are going to make me mad, and they are going to make my life miserable.
questo tipo di attività devono avere un determinato approccio.
Tante volte è capitato anche di ragazze che sono state anche vendute tra cellule criminali operanti in Italia, ma che so, faccio un esempio, da Roma a Milano o da Milano a Torino, quindi sono state anche vendute tra virgolette tra cellule criminali di cittadini nigeriani, dove c'era anche sempre il ruolo della maman che faceva un po' da protagonista, da una città all'altra.
Manca una regia a livello istituzionale. Il Dipartimento Pari Opportunità ha tentato negli anni precedenti, presso la Presidenza del Consiglio dei Ministri, di coordinare i gruppi di lavoro anche con il terzo settore, ma i risultati sono veramente molto modesti. Riindirizza direttamente sul numero di emergenza.
Ma non lo puoi chiamare.
Quindi troppo ci vuole, non lo puoi chiamare. Infatti questo...
I am free now. I am free. I'm not trafficked. Even if they are calling, they are still calling, threatening my mother. There is no amount of threatening that will make me leave this life I'm living. And I will go back. I will never do it.